Okay, 16 again is quadratic equation, but in this case the easy way for solving this quadratic equation is applying the square root principle or square root method. You take a square root here and a square root here. This is x plus 4, remember a square and a square root cancels out each other, and a square root negative 25 always imaginary number is 5i. And don't forget, please, plus or minus, because we are doing square root method, and always when you apply this method you put plus or minus. Okay, so for x is easy, is I'm moving 4 to the other side, is minus 4 plus or minus 5i. So we have two complex solutions. The complex solution are minus 4 plus 5i, comma, minus 4 minus 5i. That's it. That's the answer. Two solutions, two complex solutions. Okay, subtract two radical expressions. Remember, you can combine when you have the same radical, but you need to investigate here and here, see if possible simplification of this radical. Divided by 2 is 24. Divided by 2 is 12, divided by 2 is 6, divided by 2 is 3. So I saw one couple 2 here, another couple 2 here, that represent 1, 2 outside, and represent another 2 outside. So outside in this number we have 5 times 2 is 10 times 2 is 20. It's 20, the number outside. Radical something. The number can stay inside 3. Okay, let's see the second. The second is similar because it's 12 is, I did it, it's 2, 6, 2, 3. We have only one couple to represent 1, 2 outside. Multiplication this and this is minus, of course, minus because it's minus here. Minus, minus 4 because 2 times 2 is 4, radical 3. Ready to combine because we have the same radical, radical 3, radical 3. And you only combine the coefficients in the front. 20 minus 4, 16, radical 3. Final answer. Okay, 18. And 18 is basically rationalize the denominator. But I want to analyze two possibilities. When this monomial expression is this, and when it's binomial expression. Let's do it in the monomial, it's easy. Monomial is only multiplied by radical 7 times radical 7 because I take advantage, okay, radical any number times radical any number is a number. This is just 7. And the top we have 3 radical 7. 3 radical 7. And this is the answer. So we take the property is square root any number of expression times any number expression is any without radical. And when it's binomial, you multiply by conjugate. So this is a conjugate. This is same but different sign. And you take advantage of the multiplication. The multiplication is radical 7 times radical 7 is 7, and 2 times 2 is 4, and minus in between. And multiply this is 3 radical 7 minus 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. And 7 minus 2, minus 4 is 3. And you reduce, you simplification this, is separate into part. 3 radical 7 over 3 minus 6 over 3. Cancels out the 3, is just radical 7 minus 2. Is the answer. In this case, you take advantage when you multiply any binomial time is conjugate. It's a conjugate, the same but different sign. The answer is a squared minus b squared. So you multiply only first and last. Okay, I did radical 7 times radical 7 was 7, and 2 times 2 was 4, and minus in between. Always this minus is this minus in between. Okay, 19 is a radical equation. Let me copy again the equation, the original equation. 2x, or much better, no. I solve the radical. I move 6 to the right hand side. So say in the right hand side we have minus 2 plus 6 gets 4. And so far we have the square root 2x plus 5 equal 4. And you square both sides because I want to eliminate the radical. So it's 2x plus 5 equal 16 because 4 to the second power is 16. So for x, 2x is equal 16 minus 5. Is 11. 2x is equal 11 divided by 2. X is equal 11 over 2. And let's do the checking. Always is mandatory checking the radical equation because I don't know if this answer works or doesn't work. The radical, you're plugging 11 over 2 here and the x value. It's 2 times 11 over 2 plus 5 minus 6 should be 2. I don't know if it's true or false. These two cancels out. We have 11 plus 5 minus 6 and minus 2, sorry, here is negative 2 here. It's equal negative 2. 11 plus 5 is 16 and square root 16 is 4. 4 minus 6 should be negative 2. Negative 2 is equal negative 2, that's true. Now this solution is perfect. The solution set is the value 11 over 2 in fraction. Okay, 20 is again a word problem. This is a typical word problem we are solving using 16 of equation. Two equation and two unknown, two variable. Maria run a roadside fresh fruit stand. She sell a box of orange for $11 and box of the grapefruit for $10. One day she sold a total of 762 boxes of fruit in all and took in $8,125. How many boxes of the orange did Maria sell that day? And they suggest, can you define X like a number of the boxes of the orange that Maria sold this day, and Y is the number of the boxes of the grapefruit. Okay, for solving this problem, you have to set up the equation. Okay, so I recommend to do the equation, I recommend do the table or the chart like that. One row of the chart we define boxes, and another is the money. Okay, and we have two categories: orange and grapefruit. Okay, the problem defined that this is x and this is y. Thus it's obvious that the first equation is x plus y is equal the total. Okay, the total is 762. And this is our first equation. Can represent only boxes. The equation for the boxes. And we have the second equation can represent money. The equation for the money is just multiplication, the unitary price for each boxes of the orange, which is 11. 11 times x represent the money of the orange box only, and 10y represent the grapefruit money. When you add in this money plus this money, the answer is $8,125. And this is the second equation that represents the money. Okay? Now, the rest is algebra. The rest is solution, the system. X plus Y equals 762, equation 1. And 11X plus 10Y equals 8,125, equation 2. This is our system of equations. Well, I propose substitution. Why? Because yeah, the coefficients here in the first equation is 1. And so for example, say I want to find, well, let's solve the 60, I don't know. Y is equal 762 minus x. So for y in this equation, I move x to the right hand side. And substitution, this expression where? Substitution here, substitution in another equation here. So we have 11x plus 10 parentheses 762 minus x is equal 8125. Now distribute the property. Multiplication this and this is 11x plus 7620 minus 10x equal 8125. Now combine like term 11 minus 10, 1x. Plus 7620 is equal to 8125. Let's continue here. X is equal to 8125 subtraction 7620. The answer of the X is 505 boxes. But a box of what? Box of orange. Now this is the answer. This is the answer, boxes of orange. This is the answer that they want. However, I want to complete the solution by curiosity. Okay, if I want to find the value of the grapefruit, I substitute this box here. It says 762 minus 505. The answer is 252 boxes of the grapefruit. If you want to check in the morning, why not? Let's do the check in the morning. The check in the morning is the equation of the morning. By curiosity, right? Plugging in order to find see the total money is okay or no. Okay, so we have $11 multiplied by the amount of the box of the orange, which is 505 plus 10. Multiplied by the amount of boxes of the grapefruit is 257. Let's do the multiplication. Multiplication this and this is 5,555. Plus multiplication this and this is 2,570. When you add in this plus this, the answer is 8,125, exactly the same we expect. So the solution, guy, when you select in the test, the solution is this, because specifically they want this is the final answer. They ask about how many boxes of the orange is this answer. This answer, no, I find by curiosity. And this answer, no, I find by curiosity to checking.